I'm Dr. Marla Shapiro, a past president of the North American Menopause Society, and I'm joined by a member of the Board of Trustees of NAMS, Dr. Claudio Suarez, who is an expert in depression, particularly around menopause. He's a psychiatrist from Queen's University. Welcome.
Thank you, Marla.
So, universal complaint that a lot of us practitioners see is women complaining about mood changes in and around the time of menopause. Mm-hmm. Is it universal? Is it hormone related? What are we seeing?
It's a little bit of both. I would say most women will experience some changes, not necessarily anything important clinically, maybe some mood changes, some mood fluctuations, but overall most women would not experience depression.
So if you are experiencing depression or a mood change in and around menopause, the beginning of menopause, is that modulated by our hormones and is it expected to go away?
So hormones are probably playing a role. They're not necessarily the only role or the only factor changing moods during that time. But I would say for those who are more likely to experience mood changes related to hormonal fluctuations, they will go away eventually. So it's really related to that chaotic hormonal environment more so than the levels of hormones. So in the postmenopause, they'll get better.
Okay, now for women who do have an indication to be treated because of hot flashes and night sweats and intractable vasomotor symptoms, the hormones that we use for them, will that be beneficial or harmful when it comes to something like depression?
It depends on the time when they're using hormones.
Right.
So for those who have an indication to use hormones for, let's say, hot flashes
right.
or night sweats, they can actually benefit from that to improve their mood as well. By stabilizing the hormone environment, they might actually experience alleviation, sometimes even remission of depressive symptoms.
So the next big thing that women worry about is dementia and changes in cognition. A lot of women around menopause will tell you that they feel foggy.
Yeah.
Now, is that a true symptom of menopause? That's true, right?
Yeah, it's important even to validate those symptoms. So
right.
there have been some studies showing that even when you test their memory or their concentration, their ability to shift attention, they change over the course of the menopausal transition, early postmenopause years, but they usually go back to their normal self. So they rebound and have a regain of their attention concentration afterwards.
So a lot of women, you know, were very fearful about the use of hormones and still hanging decades later from the Women's Health Initiative. The concept of when you initiate hormones
mm-hmm.
on, let's talk about dementia and cognition.
Sure.
What windows are there for women where initiating may be okay and initiating may not be okay?
So the good news is that the window in which hormones can be helpful for your heart and for your brain and for your memory and for your mood is actually the same window.
Mm-hmm.
So the sooner they start, the better.
Right.
So if they really start around the menopausal transition, early postmenopausal years is the ideal time. And as long as they use it up to 10 years, up to the age of 60, that's the ideal window.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not really a hard cutoff.
Right. So
they should review with their physicians the time for which they should be using hormones, when to start, when to stop. But the sooner, the better.
Okay, so now let's talk about that woman who may have an established depression,
okay.
who may or may not be on menopausal hormone therapy. Is being in menopause a modifier for the type of medication that you would use to treat a clinical depression as opposed to a woman who is premenopausal or younger?
That's a very important point. Thank you for highlighting this. So for women who had experienced depression before,
mm-hmm.
They will still respond to any other treatments for depression, hormonal, non-hormonal. So
right.
antidepressants, psychotherapy can be very effective, but they can also benefit from using hormones to alleviate those symptoms. So sometimes I'll say hormones are helping the response to antidepressants, and they can also stabilize all the other symptoms, hot flashes, sleep,
right.
and anxiety. So it's important to pay attention to that. But if you're using antidepressants or other medications, so the menopause itself might bring some additional challenges,
right.
like keep your weight under control, having side effects that are affecting your sexual function. So these are all compounding issues that might happen around menopause. So it's not really treating depression at any other given time in life. You have to pay attention to things that are more menopause specific.
And obviously, it'll be patient-specific, but if we look at general classes of medications,
mm-hmm.
are there some that are more favorable as a result in the menopausal years?
So when you look at antidepressants, they all seem to have benefits during the menopause as well. But I would pay attention to those who have, particularly the SSRIs and SNRIs, There are some that might be more prone to induce weight changes or weight gain, or might be more beneficial for, let's say, alleviation of hot flashes. So these are the ones that will be paying attention more and try to adjust the doses accordingly. Mm-hmm. The other thing to pay attention is drug-drug interactions, right? So you might have women who are going through, let's say, treatment for breast cancer or other problems, and then you have to be very careful when we combine different medications to avoid that we have specific side effects.
So particularly, for example, someone who's taking tamoxifen, more likely to interact.
Yeah. So if you take, for instance, a medication that can inhibit the metabolism of tamoxifen, you might make tamoxifen less efficient, and then with that increase the risk for recurrence of breast cancer.
And in terms of the role of exercise, lifestyle, pace, respirations, biofeedback, what role does that have in the treatment of mood changes?
So for some of those things, we have more evidence than others. So there's increasing evidence of the benefits of exercise for mood, even for cognition. You might have seen recently some studies on this new hormone called irisin, which is actually released by exercise. And there are some now interesting, promising studies looking at irisin as improving mood, and it's induced by exercise. But we're still in the early stages of understanding the physiology of exercise and mood enhancement or mood changes. But overall, better, healthier lifestyle, dietary changes and exercise can alleviate or enhance mood, improve mood, but not necessarily treat clinical depression.
So for clinicians who are often focused in menopause on the hot flashes and night sweats, a question or two that they should be asking about mental health and depression.
So don't forget about the brain.
Right.
And think about the brain as also a target area that we have to pay attention when treating women going through menopause. I would say probably as women are facing hormonal changes or symptoms related to menopause, maybe ask if they had experienced any hormonally related mood symptoms in the past, the premenstrual symptoms or postpartum depression, or even simply if they have ever experienced depression before. These are women who would be more likely to experience depressive symptoms during menopause.
So I think the message that I'm hearing you tell our clinicians is that phrase you just said, don't forget about the brain.
Yeah.
Ask the questions, because you may be the only health care provider she's seeing.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.